everybody. Joe Warmbrodt, Realtor, Garcia Property, St. Louis, Team Warmbrodt Realtors. So I'm here today with Ron Ruzicka. He's with First State Bank Mortgage in St. Louis. And we're going to be discussing the topic of, if you're a buyer, could using a local lender help get my offer accepted? And pretty fascinating. So stick around and let's see what Ron has to say. Why is mortgage at the end of the name of your bank?
Oh, because we are a bank. There's different types of lenders out there. You have a bank, you have mortgage bankers and mortgage brokers. And there's definitely a distinction between all three, okay? Mm-hmm. The reason I'm with a bank is because we have bank loans, products, which we would call portfolio, that someone who doesn't fit the normal secondary market, which is where all the loans are sold, mortgages are sold, you don't fit those guidelines, but you're still a good borrower, or the property's a good piece of property, we can bring it into the bank and do a portfolio loan. And then once that issue is gone, then we can move it back into a normal product.
I've seen where, you know, banks, but the word mortgage at the end of it, that's interesting because that really talks to real estate.
It does, because basically we're a bank, and most people think of banks as checking, savings accounts, commercial mm-hmm. loans. They don't mm-hmm. think of a bank as having a mortgage department, and that's why we have mortgage behind the bank name.
I get it. You get it. But if you're not in this industry, if you're just going to buy a home in the market, you think, I'll just go with a national lender. I can get approved on my phone, you know, very easy. And hey, it's easy. I get a pre-approval, little email sent to me. But why would it even matter that a local lender like yourself would come up and be good to have in the mix for making an offer when you're purchasing a home?
Well, here's the situation is you have a realtor on the other side. They're representing the seller. So that's who you've got to impress mm-hmm. is that agent. So there are agents out there that when they see a national lender, they don't want to deal with a national lender. They want to deal with a local lender.
Why would that be that they wouldn't want to deal with a national one?
Well, it goes down to the whole scheme of how things work in the mortgage department. Mm-hmm. Each department is a little bit differently. As in my case, you're dealing with me the whole time, my processor, my assistant, and my closer. So you're dealing with just all those people, okay, during the whole process. Mm-hmm. The trouble is, and I've worked for the bigger companies, okay, mm-hmm. and I've gone very small over the life of my career. Is what you got to ask this national person that you're dealing with, are you the one who's going to walk me through this all the way to closing? Most of the time, they're just application takers, mm-hmm. okay? Mm-hmm. And they also put out pre-approval letters. Mm-hmm. And here's the situation where the realtors have found out that some of these national lenders didn't do their full due diligence, didn't follow up on what the customer was telling them, income, assets, things like that. All of a sudden, they got a pre-approval letter. And then all of a sudden, that same national lender comes back and rejects the loan, only because they didn't do their due diligence at the very beginning.
Interesting. People think, oh, well, you know, I've used this bank for my checking or my auto loan or whatever. But when you get into real estate with transactions, everyone's different. Transactions different. It can get pretty complicated and scary quick. And from what I found, it just helps having somebody that works realtor hours like we do. My wife and I, Pam, that we can call and you're going to get back to us right away. My experience with the larger banks, national, they're out at 5 or 6 p.m., you know, East Coast, and you're dead in the water if you need something overnight or later in the evening.
And that's where your question is, as a client saying, who am I dealing with through this whole transaction? Am I dealing with departments? So guess what? I start with you, Bob. But are you there the whole time, or all of a sudden I get moved to somebody else or somebody else? And here's another, just a personal philosophy. The further someone's away from you, the less mm-hmm. they worry about. Whereas with me, guess what? I see a lot of my clients in the grocery store, and the last thing I want them to do is throw a can of beans at me because they're mad because what I did to them, okay? So I think that has a lot to say about local lenders.
It does. And in this competitive markets that we're in, it's not just the price, purchase price around a contract that's going to get accepted or not. That other agent is talking to the seller probably making a spreadsheet to show all the variables of that offer and how that your offer compares to others. And when the local lender is checked, and hopefully that other agent has some knowledge of you or your company, that could make all the difference, because that agent is suggesting, whispering in the ear of the seller, hey, take this offer over another one. So it really comes into play. Just personal experience, we had a situation, my wife and I, where we were ready to close. A couple days before, the national lender said, sorry, what you're speaking to, Ryan, where the back office underwriting had no clue or no allegiance to that front person that met with the buyer.
Right.
And denied the loan. And Ryan, you came through, took a couple weeks or so, but you saved the deal, you know, and a local lender made the difference on that.
Because here it is, it's business for you, Joe, and it's business for me, okay? Mm-hmm. But for our clients, it's personal.
Yeah.
But they don't realize, and some of them don't perceive the concept that they're under a legal contract mm-hmm. to perform, okay? Mm-hmm. And the only people on that contract are the client, your client, and the seller, mm-hmm. okay? So they're asking people like me, you, building inspectors, termite guys, everybody who's involved, title company, they're mm-hmm. asking them to perform for this contract. If they don't perform, guess what? If I don't meet a loan commitment, it doesn't hurt me. It hurts my reputation, but it doesn't hurt me financially. But it hurts the client that came to me for a mortgage. So that's another issue that you got to realize. Can they perform what I need for this contract to keep me in contract? I have some clients come back to me and always say that, well, you know, Ron, your fees, your rate, everybody, the two other lenders, they're all about the same level. How do I make this decision? Mm-hmm. I said, one, your comfort level, and then go back to your realtor, and who are they asking you to go with, or who they recommend? So,
Ron, I think you answered the question then. Does it really matter if you use a local lender as a leveraging tool when a realtor writes an offer for a buyer?
Yeah, it's all about what you know. And it's an interesting market right now. And because the seller's agent has to weed out contracts, and it's mm-hmm. not necessarily the highest price. It's
right.
the one that they feel that's going to close the deal, and their sellers are going to get their money. So, and it's all about service and who's going to perform.
Again, spend some time today with Ron Ruzicka with First State Bank Mortgage. Thanks so much, Ron.
No problem, Joe. You have a good day. Be safe.
Okay, bye-bye.